The Queen of Buganda, Najinda Slivia Luswata, hosted a Queen's Ball, a prestigious dinner through the Nawagereka Fund to raise mental health awareness and raise money to treat people with mental problems in Buganda. During this first ever Queen's Ball, dedicated to supporting mental health, the Nawagereka highlighted the impact of mental health on individuals, families and communities.
Apparently, most of the cases in mental health are actually those ones that you cannot notice. It's not the ones, you know, where people are very disgruntled and you can obviously see that that there's something wrong. It's the very sometimes referred to as maybe mild cases. They may not be so mild actually, but they're the ones that carry the most percentage. Doctor, you may.
Through this initiative, there is hope to destigmatize mental health and ensure that those in need have access to resources that they require. The Nawagereka Fund shall provide financial support to initiatives and organizations that focus on mental health awareness, education, advocacy, and treatment. The event, hosted at Serena Hotel in Kampala, attracted a multitude of VIPs, including the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, the Buganda Kingdom Premier, Charles Peter Mayiga, and many other delegates. In Sironko District today, the Member of Parliament for Budadidi West Constituency, Nathan Nandalama Fabi, was among the first citizens to be counted in the ongoing national census. After participating in the exercise at his residence in Busamaga, Nandala urged members of the Budadidi West Constituency and Bugisu at large to embrace the exercise, underscoring the immense benefits for the community.
My call in the public is all of you must be counted. And I want everybody to give as much as possible factual information. Don't fear, don't say any question is bad. Those questions are very good. If they ask you, do you want to commit suicide? If you don't, you do. But if you have some of those sounds, that people who are sleeping, they're hearing voices. He says, I slept hearing voice. Tell them.
Whereas the exercise appeared to be running smoothly, some enumerators highlighted the challenges they have encountered, among which is the terrain and bad weather.
Last night was the census night, beginning from midnight, and we have started well. We had the floating population, which we counted. We had the people traveling at night. We had the children on the street. We had quite a number that we are moving, and we counted all of those.
Regardless of the hiccups on the first day of the exercise, the communities are cooperating during the exercise. Poor and impassable access road network have led to the delay in the commencement of the enumeration exercise in Butaleje district. Most village roads have been flooded and rendered impassable, a challenge enumerators have to cope with to access homes. Kenneth Masika is one of the enumerators who is tasked with a target of 10 homes by the end of the day. He says the immense challenges could impede the exercise.
I'm supposed to cover 10 houses a day, and with the situation now, I may fail due to the situation of the area being flooded, and it takes a long time to access another home.
Tata Samson, the district census officer for Utalija, says on the first day, enumerators are experiencing challenges of not accessing maps as well as login challenges, but UBOS officials are trying to resolve the technicalities so as to enable enumerators meet the target. Apollo Liada, the Prime Minister for Wamile Culture Institution, has rallied Butaleja community members to embrace the National Population Housing Census, saying it will help the government to plan better for its people and culture institutions.
We have embraced the population and housing census wholeheartedly. Actually, when UBOS wrote to Professor Erwe Sanachomi to pattern in sensitizing the community towards embracing the population and housing census for this year, we wholeheartedly took it on. We responded on 30th March.
Butaleja is one of the districts ranked with high poverty levels, characterized with bad roads, infrastructure, and poor services. The cultural leadership is optimistic that relevant data from this census could inform government of the much needed support for developing the community. Leaders in Namayingo district have asked the concerned authorities to put on halt the construction of Shen Sugar Factory, citing illegalities. Among issues raised by the district councillors is lack of environmental assessment reports and approval documents from National Environment Management Authority, NEMA. Omolos Musa, the Namayingo District Council Speaker, says that they have resolved to halt activities at the factory until they are cleared by NEMA. However, the district vice chairperson, Kauta Abdallah Twaha, is opposed to the decision, citing the benefits the district would lose. He further claims the factory management has necessary clearance to operate. The construction of Shen Sugar Factory started last year in Sangobi Village, Sango Parish, in Buinja Sub-County. The management of Shen Sugar Factory was not available for comment on the matter.